What's up, y'all? It's Stacey Asia. We back with another reaction video. Today, y'all, we got Hurricane Hillary ruined the DDG mansion, and he is moving out. We all know this BS. Let's get into it.
Ants. Yeah, I just came back from...
Ants is probably one of the worst things that can happen. They aggravate.
Very much so. And they come in
groups
with people.
They don't just come by themselves.
Exactly.
He's in Palm Springs.
Y'all must have left something sticky out.
Mm-hmm.
My house is infested with ants, bro. I don't know what just happened, bro. I just had to throw away all this good seasoning. I threw away. They was all stuck on this syrup bottle. I threw away all my seasoning, all my food, everything, basically. And I don't know what to do at this point, bro. Like, I feel disgusted, man. Ugh. Like, it's so many ants. But they only in this one area, so I'm not really that scared. But I mean, I ain't scared at all. But like, yeah, it's kind of nasty, bro. What the fuck were they everywhere?
It happens. Mm-hmm. It happens.
Nasty. Ugh.
It's all right. I'm see all that syrup after, by the way, in there.
I don't play that dirty shit, man. So when I see stuff like this, it just give me like an ick. I'm like, ugh. So I got to figure out a way to get rid of all of these ants right now. This is making me feel some type of way. It's terrible. It ain't that mean. I guess it could be worse, but still, the fact of the matter is, like, I'm a clean dude, bro. I ain't dealing with no ants, man.
Them ants got excited, y'all wasn't there.
And you left
and they
them.
Said, let's make a move.
Now I'm getting mad, bro. I don't even want to. It's disgusting. I'm thinking, should I bait them?
Bait them.
Should I put a little bit of honey down, right? Have them come to the honey and then kill them all. Should I do that?
No. It's just going to draw more.
Yeah.
This might be a dumb idea, but I'm going to try it. I look a little crusty this morning, man. You know, I just woke up damn near. Came back to the crib. Woo woo. Yeah, so I'm gonna put this little thing down right here. They gonna love that. They like, oh, we finally got some food.
Nah, they don't have food.
Get y'all some honey. Get y'all some honey. There you go. Yeah. Yeah, get the honey, man. Get the honey. Go and get the honey. Mm-hmm. Like, oh, shit. Hey, y'all. Hey, y'all. Something over here smell good, man. Y'all go tap in, bro. Something over here smell good, y'all. Look up on everything, bro. Look, he smell it. He's
like, come on. Like, wait a minute now. Wait a minute now.
Oh, okay. We hit the jackpot. Y'all, pull up. Everybody, pull up. We got something. Yeah, keep eating it. Dummy. Yeah, hop up on here, man. I'll be right back. Yeah, I gotta go to the stove, man. I used to have a little vacuum that I could just suck them all up with. I don't know where it's at, so I'm finna.
I mean, that's one way to do it.
You don't know where your vacuum is?
Do you mean it's the regular stuff I do that y'all don't get to see? You know what I mean?
What?
But I'm just straight rapping, you know, like stuff like this. But if you on my Snapchat, you already seen this. Make sure y'all follow me on Snapchat at Pontiac Made DDG.
Yep.
His Snapchat be funny, y'all.
Very much.
Grab me a little vacuum and suck every single ant up. No homo. I suck all these ants up, put them in a vacuum, throw them away. Boodle boom, bam, bang. Yeah, I miss vlogging my side missions, man. This is just, I do side missions all the time, bro. I just never, like, get the broadcast or do nothing, so. A little, I feel like people just think that I'm just some superhuman or something like that, and I don't do regular stuff, but I do regular human stuff every day, bro. I'm like, just like y'all be forgetting that, bro. Like, I'm no better than you, bro. I just got more money than your daddy. That's literally the only difference between me and you. Came here for a vacuum, bro. These vacuums are $600, bro.
Yeah, good one.
Yeah. You want me buying another one for a while?
What?
Unless you lose it too.
$620 for a vac. That's how much I spend in vacuums these days. I got marble floors, so I ain't never got a vacuum. So
I mean,
I ain't know that.
You still can that.
Instead of sweeping.
Yeah. Trap I set y'all. Worked out perfectly. They all flocking to it. All trying to get some honey. They all going in the same place that I need them to go.
But they everywhere.
This homie,
yeah.
Everything on that counter need to be washed.
Yeah.
Yay!
That's a good one. You don't even got to have that mug plugged in.
Okay, I want that vacuum. Me too.
Gonna get them. Dummies.
Now you could have.
Come on down. Yeah. Y'all come see me. Yeah, y'all stuck in there forever now. Yup, dummies. Now y'all stuck.
Can I have a, hold on 1 second.
No worries.
What should I get y'all? I don't know.
Get,
where he at?
Starbucks.
You know.
Caramel Ribbon Crunch.
Let me have
almond milk.
Damn, I don't know.
Go two ahead. Shots of espresso. Extra
what is
crunch.
The Starbucks Reserve Iced Latte?
The Reserve Iced Latte?
Yeah, what is it?
She got an ass.
She could have said, hold on or something.
Right. I hello? Hate when people don't do that. Say hello.
Give me 1 second.
Okay.
You could have said that from the jump.
Attitude.
Okay.
I'm a little crusty, man. I gotta clean up. Okay, let me just get let me just have an iced caramel macchiato.
Iced caramel macchiato?
Yeah, grande.
Okay.
And can I get an extra shot of espresso in it?
Extra shot of espresso, okay.
And then let me get a spinach feta egg white wrap.
Okay.
And that's all.
All right, let me know what's exact for you.
All right. I ended a Q&A in a minute, y'all. So I figured I'd go ahead and do one of those today. Today is a cool day, man. Y'all know I don't do, I'm a regular human. I feel like a lot of y'all forget that. But I'm a regular human, y'all. Sometimes I don't do much. You know, sometimes I just chill at home, or sometimes I just play the game and sit at home all day and level up on Call of Duty, or, you know, play some solos on Fortnite or whatever, you know, because that's what I'm good at. I know a lot of y'all don't know how to play video games, so y'all wouldn't relate to that. But sometimes I just want to kick it at the crib, where I go to the studio for 12 hours and I don't film nothing, you know. But I'm trying to keep it daily for y'all, so it's already 5:30 here in L.A., so that's 8:30 on the East Coast. I got to get y'all something before it's too late. But I am going to Drake concert tonight. I'm surprising Hallie with tickets. So I'm about to take her to the Drake concert. So I'm going to vlog a little bit of that. So, but that'll be in tomorrow's vlog. So make sure y'all subscribe. Stay tuned. Press post notifications. And yeah, make sure y'all follow me on Snapchat. That's where I post the most every day. I don't miss a day on Snapchat. Trust and believe. Anybody that watch my Snapchat, vouch for me in the comments right now. Let them know, man.
Don't miss a day.
He don't, because I make sure to watch it, because it'd be funny.
Mm-hmm.
Answer some questions. Go about my dizzy. All right, y'all. Let's get into this Q&A. I got a few little snacks to keep me level head.
What's that?
Mm-hmm. I'm wondering the same thing. I ain't never seen that, I don't think.
Me neither. There must be something up there on the West Coast. Oh my God.
Whatever it is, he needs like.
It might go down better. You take that ski mask off. All
right.
It's giving Bojang, I mean, Popeye's biscuit.
How about it? Love Lonnie said, is there anything on your bucket list for the rest of the year? I want to drop an album before the end of the year. A very well thought out cohesive album, uplifting words. Like, I feel like the reason why hip-hop is so low. Hip-hop is the least streamed / bought genre of all time right now at this very moment. Like 2017, 2018, 2019, up and right before the pandemic, hip-hop was number one. The charts was filled with all hip-hop songs. And I feel like now it's at the lowest it's ever been. And I feel like it's because we're not rapping about anything anymore. As a nigga, as a dude that raps. Point.
As a listener who used to listen to almost nothing but hip-hop, now I don't listen to nothing but old school and R&B.
I listen to gospel.
And I listen to DDG music when he put it out. You know what I'm saying? I listen to his music, and there might be one or two other artists I listen to, but I used to have like a playlist just full of hip-hop artists. I don't even go to the, like when I go looking for music, I don't even go to browse hip-hop, like looking for new artists and stuff like that. I don't even do that no more.
That's because they're in there. Everybody sound the same.
They ain't hitting on nothing. That's just honesty.
I can admit that. We don't rap about nothing. The littest songs in hip-hop right now ain't about nothing, for real. Let's be honest. We just rapping. We just saying the same thing, flexing money, cars, and stuff like that. And I admit, I do the same thing, but it's you just don't know. But I feel like I want to make an album that's very well thought out. Every song is cohesive. Every song has a message. Every song is meant to make you feel some type of way. I'm working on songs right now where I get in the studio, I might listen to the beat for like 30 minutes and write the song down well thought out and really have a concept in my head that can really grab somebody, you know, whether it's uplifting, making somebody feel better, or exposing somebody, or you know, just really reading people's minds. So before the end of the year, that's my goal. I'm going to make it happen. Love Lonnie also said, top three artists in your playlist right now. I would say, well, I listen to Gunna a lot. I feel like Gunna had the hardest album of this year, and nobody ain't gonna say it because the little situation or whatever. But in my personal opinion, as a listener, Gunna had the best album this year thus far, no matter what.
I'm gonna go listen.
That's
to
the truth, bro. I'm being one. I'm being 1,000.
Let me write it down so I don't forget.
3-3-3.
Gunna had the best album, bro. Let's be honest, bro.
3-3-3.
He ain't missed once. I say Gunna, Drake, Future. Like my top three that I really listen to in my playlist. Future going stupid, going dumb. Yeah, I say that's my top three. But I listen.
I haven't checked out Future music in a while.
Me neither.
So I'm gonna have to, I wrote him down too, so I can go listen. Go listen to some of his new music.
Listen to all music though. Like I don't just listen to rap, y'all. Like I listen to pop, rock. Yeah, I don't listen to rock, I'm lying. I listen to pop. I listen to R&B. I listen to everything. Like I'm starting to listen to country music. I'm not gonna lie.
Me too.
I would listen to Spanish music if I understood the language, because it sounds cool. But I've been listening to pop, rap, little tiny bit of country. Country is what rappers, hip hop. As a hip hop artist, we need to look at these country dudes, because what they be rapping, what they be talking about, be real life stuff.
Yeah, they be talking.
I like country music. It's something that's genuinely like they talking about something.
Yeah,
I like country music. How much longer we have to wait for tour? Not too long, but I think I want to go on tour with another artist, y'all. I don't think I'm ready for my own headline tour, not yet. Yeah, I should have went on a headline tour for the last project. Not maybe it's me, but the one before that. And for sure, Die for Respect. I did go for Die for Respect. I went with Kevin Gates. But I feel like I should have went for the last project. I feel like this project is not really tour worthy to me personally as somebody that made it. So when an album drop that I feel confident about, and I know it's, I put my all into it, that's when I'm going to go out. I'm not in a rush at all. Best live concert performance you ever seen? The best live concert that I ever seen thus far. I only been to a few concerts. My first concert I ever been to was Young Thug and 21 Savage. I got free tickets from SeatGeek. I never been to a concert ever in my life until that time. My second concert, I went to Rolling Loud probably in like 2020. I don't go to concerts like that. But I went to Rolling Loud Thailand, I performed, and then the next day I went to go see Travis Scott perform. Mm. Travis Scott is the best performer of all time. Shoot me. I done seen him. His energy is out of control. So I would say that's probably the best performance that I done seen. And then next, Beyonce. I seen Beyonce in Dubai. That was amazing. That's true talent. In terms of like energy, them two different shows though. In terms of like energy, I would say Travis Scott. It's just super lit. People jump on stage and then he throw them back in the crowd. It's just a bunch of stuff going on. Okay.
Sound lit.
If music and fame went away tomorrow, what would you see yourself doing? I think I would be a manager. Not gonna lie, y'all. Like, I genuinely enjoy helping people. Like, if I got $1 million today and I can show and I got a homie that ain't got it, bro, I would literally sit you down and teach you how to make the million that I just made. You feel me? Like, I just love helping people. I love guiding people. Like, I feel like if I wasn't doing this, I would be a manager, music exec, or anything like that. Like, I definitely would be in a high paying field. I'm not gonna sit here and lie to y'all and say, hey, I'll be a firefighter or a policeman. I don't understand that, to be honest with y'all. Not stunting on nobody, but if you ain't working a 9-to-5, bro, like, I ain't finna go through police school, bro. It's just not on me. Like, I don't know how I got into that, but I just don't understand police officers, bro. Y'all putting your life on the line for 50 bands, bro. I don't understand. It might be a police officer watching this right now, bro. Don't arrest me. I'm just saying. I just
don't arrest me.
I don't understand it. But it definitely would be something high paying. I feel like I'd be a high manager on some Scooter Braun level. You feel me? I'd be like, you know, I'd be on some QCP type shit, you know? I feel like that's what I'd be on, whether it's music or just regular media. Are you going to grab another big custom chain? Yes, I am. I had one in the works. I was supposed to have it by now, but I was procrastinating. I just don't know, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I got a custom chain made before, and I hated it, and I made them remake it, and I waited a month for it. So, I just want to make sure I spend top dollar, and I go to the right person, because I want, like, a cross, Bugatti's, diamonds, like, I want a different chain, like, I want something real nice. Like, I like Lil Uzi chain. Not that I'm copying his chain, but I like this new chain. It's like a little cross. It's dope. Like, I like something like that. Like, I want something cool like that. So that's what I've been working on. I got one already in the works, but I'm just trying to make sure that I really, really enjoy the design before I put my money into it. How much longer are you going to stay in LA? I don't know. I feel like I get a second spot before I move out of here. It's just hard to relocate, especially I got family here. Like, if I ever get bored, if I'm ever bored, y'all, I go to my brother's house. Or go to my mama's house, and I sit there for hours and hours and hours and hours just so I can be having some company. So, I don't know. The taxes is definitely out of control.
I thought that was something on our end.
Sooner than later. But for right now, I'm chilling. Will you ever quit YouTube? No, I would not. I don't think I will ever quit YouTube for the simple fact that it's me. That's the truth. I can't run away from it. Even if I try to, like, I'm a YouTuber, y'all. Like, I'm a YouTuber and I'm an entertainer. I'm an artist. I'm a designer.
Hold up.
Rapper, singer, whatever. Like, I'm just everything, bro. Like, nobody told Jamie Foxx, hey, bro, you a actor rapper. Hey, bro, you're actor singer. You're a singer actor. You're not a real. No, Jamie Foxx got hits and he in movies. Like,
okay,
you can't stop somebody. I just get bored easily, bro. Like, I gotta do a lot. I gotta do everything. And I don't think I will ever quit YouTube because it gives me so much satisfaction. I love it. If you had to choose one, would you choose YouTube or Snapchat? I would choose Snapchat. Let me tell you why. Snapchat is just more real time. It's so much easier to post. Like, after I get done with this, I have to edit it. I have to upload it. I have to wait maybe 30 minutes to an hour for it to go up.
Yep.
And then I have to put ads on it. And then I have to put a thumbnail on it. Like, it's a lot of work to post.
Snapchat, you just post.
Facts.
Snapchat. I'm posting pictures, videos, and about a snap. I just snapped. Like, I just made. I went to the store, y'all. I ain't even vlogging. I went to the store to get some clothes for the concert tonight, and
put it on Snapchat.
Snapped 100 snaps, and I got a large fan base on there. Yesterday, I got 2 million views on my story. 24-hour story, 2 million views. No rap cap at all. I'll show you the screenshot. Make sure y'all go follow me on there, y'all. Like, I really be on there a lot. I would definitely choose Snapchat if I had to choose one of them, but I'd much rather do both. When you dropping a song, when I'm dropping an official song, I want it to be something well thought out. I want it to be a banger, something that, you know, I really, really, truly believe in. Not that I don't believe in the songs that I drop, but when I post stuff on YouTube, it really just be for fun, y'all. Like, I just gotta feel that voice sometimes, and I just gotta put something out and just feel it a little bit. So I'm probably gonna post. I shot a music video when we was in Palm Springs. I'm gonna drop that. It's something fun though. It's something for y'all to, you know, vibe to, kick it for the time. You know, iCarly freestyle type shit. So I'm probably gonna drop that maybe tomorrow or the next day. Before I go to Japan, I'm gonna drop a whole nother video, music video on YouTube. But when it comes to dropping like an official song, very, very soon. I'm thinking September, middle of September, and then going to an album October. That's what I'm aiming for. Don't know if it's gonna happen. Don't quote me, but that's what I'm working on. Get back on stream. I will never stream again, y'all. I quit. Cause the world not ready for me live, bro. Like, the world is not ready for me live. Me getting on Twitch, I done created more beef for myself than I ever created in a span of 2 months. Like,
because he speaks his mind. That's why.
Me streaming is dumbing down my quality of a human. It's dumbing down my quality as an entity, as DDG. I'm giving y'all too much. And it's hard, bro. Like, streaming is very, very fun. I very much enjoyed it. But you really got to sit in that room for 8 hours, bro. Like, got to sit in that room for 5-6 hours. And it's like, bro, I'm moving around. I'm an artist, bro. Like, I gotta do stuff. I got to move around. I got to, you know what I'm saying? It's just not ideal for my career. But big ups to everybody that's doing it. You know, it's very, very lucrative when it comes to money. And I'm happy for anybody that's killing it. But I can't do what Kai do, bro. I can't do it with your age do. I can't do it, bro. Like, I just can't. Like, I've been had to fight somebody. Like, it's just too much, bro. The internet shit, like, people just talk too crazy on there. And I can't handle it, bro. I crash out on the internet. And y'all don't even be noticing. Y'all think I just be joking, but I really be dead ass mad. I'm like, I can't even do that, bro. I gotta chill. You in talks with Keemstar for a boxing match? No, I'm not. But I might box again. I'm thinking about it. I might box. I need a tune-up fight, though, y'all. I'm weak. I'm rusty. So if any of y'all grandpas or 5-year-old nephews want to get in there so I can tune up, I might jump in there for that.
Not 5-year-old nephews.
I might hop in the ring again some point in time. Definitely. Just, I feel like just boxing in general is like, you really got to dedicate a lot of time to it. So I got to really have a window where I'm not doing nothing to really get into it. How many times a week do you hit the gym? I try 3 or 4 times a week. I haven't went to the gym this week because I just went on vacation. I did go to the gym for a little bit, got a little pump in while I was there. But I didn't go to the gym this week. But once, but I try like 3-4 times a week. At minimum. Somebody said, why are people clowning on your greatness? I don't think people clowning on my greatness. I feel like people are... I know this dude named Korn, y'all. He a Twitter dude, right? Dude named Korn. I'm cool with him. He probably tweeted some stuff about me a few times. But, you know, we met in person. We cool. We locked in. You feel me? I feel like everybody that meet me... Be like, oh, DDG actually a cool dude. Like, he not even really arrogant or nothing like that. Like, when I be flexing, I be joking, y'all. Like, I don't really be, like, I'm a very humble person. And honestly, y'all, my brother I'm more humble than my brother. Like, I'm,
oh, we know.
I'm very humble.
We know.
I'm super duper humble. I don't know if it just comes off that way, but like, I'm very humble, y'all. I love uplifting people. I am very, very aware of the great position that I'm in. I thank God for all my success and everything. Not saying my brother don't, but I'm saying like, my brother will flex on you before I do. But I know this dude named Korn, and he making like 50 bands on Twitter. So I feel it. People tweet about me because it gets engagement on Twitter.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like a little trend or whatever. So everybody getting their bag. I don't even, bro, y'all keep tweeting, bro. Y'all got to feed y'all families too. I'm not going to stop y'all from feeding y'all families, bro. Do what y'all got to do. Twitter make money. And guess what I did? I went on my shit and I figured out I can monetize too. So I might start tweeting about y'all. So I get it. I understand it. I don't think people clown on my greatness. I feel like definitely the trend of hating on DDG has made people get misconstrued of how talented and great I am and the impact that I've had on the black community and any minority community or any community in general
mm-hmm.
on the internet. Has definitely been, people have the wrong idea of me off of that trend of hate. But in reality, the people that know of me, which is a lot of people, they know that, you know, I'm a good dude. I come with a lot of stuff. And, you know, I've created this great life for me and my family. And I feel like a lot of people know that. They might not flat out say it or defend me online, but I feel like the majority of people know that. The people that don't know of me definitely don't like me off
mm-hmm.
of other
people's
opinions, exactly. Which is cool. I feel like people will come around at some point. But it don't really bother me no point at this point, y'all. Like, I've been getting hated on for damn near 6-7 months now. Like, it's whatever, bro. I take it with a grain of salt. At first, it was bothering me, but now I really don't care. Somebody said, when will you actually get a team? For y'all that don't know, I do not have a manager. I don't have an assistant. I don't have a nothing. I have nothing, y'all. Like, people don't understand that, bro. I'm still staying afloat. I ain't got no team, bro. Like, the people that's at my caliber of music,
they have teams.
A full-blown team. They have mm-hmm. everything. They got assistants, people that roll their blunts for them. They got people that, you know what I'm saying, they do everything for them. I don't have nothing. And it's not that it's a flex. It's just I haven't found my team yet. Like, I'm still actively searching. I'm trying to figure out, like, what I want in a manager. You know what I'm saying? Like, what do I need help with? I recently been in talks with a PR. I don't even have a PR, y'all. Like, which explains probably my.
You, I about to say, you definitely needed a PR. We said that before.
I don't have a PR. I don't have no team at all, y'all. I'm raw dogging it. But you know what I do got? I got 100% of everything.
That's a fact.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me? But you know, you gotta break bare with people to get to the next level of success. So. I'm working on a team, working on getting a manager, working on getting an assistant. An assistant is kind of hard. It was hard for me to trust Ed. And me and Ed was like, you know what I'm saying? Me and Ed bump heads a few times. It was hard for me to trust him for real because I just don't like hanging out with new people like that. Like, I'm not like a very friendly person. I'm not like a very like, hey, y'all, let's be friends. Like, that's never mm-hmm. been me. Like, I tell y'all all the time, I'm very introverted, extremely. So I don't like reach out to people or nothing like that. So It's going to be hard for me to find an assistant, somebody I can hang out with every single day. Also for a manager, somebody I could put the trust into my career and giving them a percentage or something, like, just a little hard. One thing I do got, I got a lawyer, and I got, I'm working on getting a PR. So I'm figuring everything out, y'all. So I am
lawyer definitely necessary.
To find a team mm-hmm. to definitely further my career for Shorsky. Somebody said, why are you going to Japan? I'm going to Japan because I want to go to Japan. I have absolutely no reason why I'm going. I just called my brother, called DeShay, and I was like, yeah, let's go to Japan, you know? And then we just bought our tickets, man. We blessed to do that, obviously, but I'm just excited to go. I go in a couple days, and a lot of other people just went to Japan, so I'm like, yeah, I want to see what all the hype about, so... I never been before. I'm very excited. I love technology. I heard they got
Would you go to Japan?
Yeah, I would go.
I would definitely go.
Sean be wanting to go to Japan.
Well, we're gonna have to take him to Japan.
Yeah, I can see him now. It'll be Naruto, everything.
Surrounds with robot surgery.
Man.
I can't wait.
It looked dope, though.
I'm
gonna
go crazy with the videos. Does. And I got a good news for y'all. I got a cameraman. It ain't Ed. Ed got a new job. He cheating on me. But I got another cameraman. Got his flight already. He pulling up. So I'm gonna have a third person vlog for y'all coming up in Japan.
So is Ed gone for good?
Y'all like how he work?
Maybe till he done with the job he doing.
Y'all the hirers, bro. I don't hire nobody.
You don't know what he doing.
We gonna see. Yeah. So it's gonna be lit. I'm going to Japan in a couple days. Turn on post notifications. I will be vlogging. I will be Snapchatting 24/7. Okay? Please and thank you. I love y'all. I can't wait to give y'all more content. I can't
chat that thing cold and hard
to very continue much, the son. Rest of the year. I can't wait to inspire more of you. He I don't can't care. Wait to continue and do everything in this new chapter that I got. You know, all my old videos gone, so we're kind of starting over. So I'm just excited. I love y'all from the bottom of my heart. The people that's watching these videos right now, y'all don't understand how much trial and tribulation and how much stuff I done went through mentally over this past few months that I had to train. But you know, it made me stronger. I had to train my brain to understand that people don't understand me. Not everybody gonna like me.
Mm-hmm.
And over the for 90% of my career, I've been loved. I've been liked. So, you know, something new to me, and I appreciate y'all for sticking with me, and it means a lot. I want y'all to know that. And yeah,
Wachowski.
That's what I got to say.
Okay.
I'm finna get ready to go to this concert. I'm finna get my hair retwisted, get right.
Y'all know what it is. We finna be on to the next video. So drop us a comment down below, and we're gonna catch you on the next one. Peace.